guys, it's JJ, and this is Today with JJ. As you guys can see by the title of the video, these are 10 things to do in the South Florida area, specifically Fort Lauderdale and Miami. I'm going to break it down with 5 things to do in Fort Lauderdale and 5 things to do in Miami. The great thing is that Fort Lauderdale and Miami are about a 25 to 30-ish minutes, depending on the area that you're deciding to go to. So if you decide to come down to Fort Lauderdale, you can stay in any one of those places, and there's great cities in between them that you can stay at that'll keep you connected with both areas. So let's jump right in to the video. So let's start off with the more northern region, which is Fort Lauderdale, Broward County. It's awesome for families, especially families with younger children. And if you're coming in the fall or during the holiday season, you can't miss the big snowman on Fort Lauderdale Beach. So that's my number one recommendation. If you don't do anything when you come to South Florida, make sure you visit Fort Lauderdale Beach. Just the way that it's set up is so awesome. It's really chill. You have the beautiful beach, a little bit of a strip that you can walk up and down, and really good eatery. You have everything from the big chains like Bubba Gump to more smaller, intimate places, all trickled in between. Now, the second thing I would recommend that you do while you're in Fort Lauderdale, and this is great for couples or if you're going with a group of friends, is to visit Las Olas. So Las Olas is the party scene, the party area in Fort Lauderdale, and it's located in the downtown area. The third thing that I recommend doing while you're in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, is you have to visit the Primanti Brothers. This is after a night of partying down on Las Olas. You'll come right back down to the beach. You'll walk a little ways down, and Primanti Brothers is open 24 hours. You can get everything from their very famous pastrami sandwich to what one of my favorites is, their pizza. It is awesome. The next thing I would recommend is really great for anyone who's going, whether you're by yourself, with a spouse, with your family, with friends, doesn't matter. You have to go to Sawgrass Mills. It's one of the biggest outlet malls in the South Florida area. And when I tell you, deals galore. And what's so amazing is within the last few years, they have a whole designer section, and absolutely, hands down, one of the best designer outlet shops. And last but not least in Fort Lauderdale, if you don't do anything, make sure to make your way to experience Off the Beaten Path, and it's super cool, especially for my video game lovers. It's called the 10th Level Tavern. That's located in Fort Lauderdale. Great thing with that, they're open super late on Tuesdays, and they have karaoke night. It's a video game bar, so any type of video game you can think of is available there. And what's very, very cool about it is right across the road, Funky Buddha, which is a brewery, super popular, especially on that Tuesday night. And right next to it, best Caribbean food that you can ever eat. It's called Alberti's. So they're all right in the same areas. They're right across the street from each other. It's really a good option to do if you want to do something off the beaten path. There's so many cool locals that hang out there, and it is a great time. Now let's jump into my favorite city, Miami. Miami is such a lively city. I recommend this for girls' trips, guys' trips, couples. If there is a family that wants to go, usually with older children. I mean, there are things to do for younger kids, but it gives your older kids a little bit of freedom to hang out on the beach and for you and your spouse to find something great to do. In Miami, there are so many different parts. You have everywhere from North Miami all the way down to the Grove and even further down, but that's a whole nother story for another day. So let's start with North Miami. One of my favorite places, if we're talking about shopping, is the Aventura Mall. It is humongous and it has some of the great designer selections there. There's also everything else in between, like Urban Outfitters, you have H&M. Now, once we go a little bit further down, we're going to hit that Midtown area. What I love, absolutely love about Midtown is that it has three districts in one. You have the fashion district, you have the design district, and you have the downtown area. So the downtown area is the home to the AAA Center, and there are beautiful lakes and canals all over the place. When you're in the Midtown area, the fashion district is exactly what you think it is. All those Instagrammable pictures that you see, especially with those orange pillars, that is the Fendi shop. So you can find places like Fendi, Hermes, Dior, all of the big brands are located in that area. And when I tell you, it is a selfie mecca or an Instagram mecca, you can get great, great, wonderful pictures in that area. Now, the next one is one that's really close to my heart, and that is South Beach. South Beach is awesome. It is a whole day experience. You can enjoy the beach, the wonderful water, the beautiful people walking on the beach during the day, and then switch it over to the nighttime and you'll see Ocean Drive lit up with all of the Art Deco buildings. It is an experience. And now going down a little bit further down, it is a little bit popular, but not as popular with tourists. I really like the Coconut Grove area, because in the Coconut Grove area you have something called Coco Walk, which is very similar to the vibe and feel of the Fort Lauderdale beach, just without the beach. It's only 5 minutes south from South Beach, 5 to 7 minutes max, and you're in Coconut Grove. Another great thing with Coconut Grove is that you will really get to see what Miami is about. There's a lot of beautiful homes there if you want to drive around and take in the scenery. There are also other places that you can go to, like in Kendall. They have the Kendall Mall as well. There's also really great food all up and down Coconut Grove, especially if you want any type of Hispanic food, any type, especially Cuban food. You have to get Cuban food if you're in Miami. And last, we're gonna say last but not least in Miami, one of my favorite things to do in Miami is to drive down to Key Biscayne. It was home to the 2018 Miami Open and one of my very favorite hotels, which is the Ritz-Carlton, is located in that area. And I tell you, if you want an unforgettable, it is very romantic. It's a romantic experience. The Ritz-Carlton in Key Biscayne is a must. So guys, those are the 10 things that I recommend to do in South Florida while you're there. And again, don't forget, they're only 25 minutes from each other. Well guys, thank you again so much for coming by my channel. If you're not yet subscribed, go ahead and click that subscribe button. And also don't forget to click the bell notification button so you're notified every time I post a video. And until tomorrow, I love y'all. Bye.